Hello, and welcome to the AWS Builder Guides. My name is Jim Loveland. I'm a solutions architect at AWS. In this tutorial, we'll learn about AWS Cost Categories, a tool that allows you to group your AWS costs in ways that align with your business needs. After a brief introduction to the tool and its use cases, I'll show you how to use it in the AWS console. In AWS, the basic category for accounting and billing is the account. AWS Organizations allows you to centralize billing for multiple accounts into a single payer account. AWS Cost Categories allows you even more freedom in how you group your cost and usage information, by project, say, or by team. It allows you to allocate shared costs to entities in your enterprise according to rules that you define. And the groups and rules you define in Cost Categories can be propagated to other AWS financial management tools, as we will see in the demo. For purposes of the demo, I created this fictitious organization chart for any company incorporated in order to illustrate three common use cases for cost categories. The first question we might ask if you're an executive of any company is, how do I allocate costs by team? The costs are reported by account by default, but we have two accounts per team. The second question we might ask is how we can allocate costs by project. In this example, we have two different teams spinning up resources to work on Project A and Project B. How do I account for the total cost of Project A? The third question we might ask is how we allocate a shared cost. In other words, a cost that is paid for by a central account, but which needs to be charged back to business units, teams, or accounts that actually consume the service. Examples might be support charges, networking services, or reserved instance savings that are actually initially attributed to a payer account. Now I will enter my AWS console and show you how to answer all three of these questions using AWS Cost Categories. I'm in the home screen of my AWS account. Cost Categories is a feature in the billing and cost management service. So I will navigate there and then click on Cost Categories in the left-hand menu. In the interest of time, I'm simply going to walk you through the cost categories that I created previously, beginning with team. When you first create a cost category, you choose a name, and then you make a choice of the look-back period. You can either apply this cost category from this month forward in time, or you can apply it retroactively for the previous 12 months. So here I've defined two team cost categories. Team A is going to consist of these two accounts, and Team B consists of these two accounts. Once I've defined that, I click Next. If you were doing this for the first time, you would have a chance to create the cost category as opposed to saving the changes. The second cost category we're going to review is that of project. Here, we're going to define Project A as consisting of everything that has a cost allocation tag with the key value pair of project name equal to Project A. Project B is defined as everything, all resources that have the cost allocation tag with the key value pair of project name equal to Project B. Click Next. Now I'm going to show you how to allocate shared costs. But before I do so, I want to step back to our organization chart and show you what I want to do. We've already created cost categories for project and team. Behind the scenes, I've gone ahead and created three more cost categories at the next highest level of aggregation: Business Unit 1, Business Unit 2, and a Shared Services Business Unit cost category. So as a next step, we are going to take the shared services costs and allocate them to the other two business units, which represent any company's cost centers. So here I am back in the console, and I'm going to edit and show you what I've done with the shared costs category. So I've gone in and defined cost center one as consisting of business unit one, cost center two consisting of business unit two, and then the shared cost to split consisting of the shared services business unit. I'm going to hit next. And unlike in the previous examples, I click the button to add a split charge. And what we get now is this screen here that gives us the option to choose which costs do we want to split. And in our case, I chose the shared costs. And where do you want to allocate them? That's the target value. I chose cost center one and cost center two. And here we get to choose the formula we're going to use to allocate those costs. I chose to allocate them in a fixed proportion with 50% going to each of the two cost centers. Now I want to show you how we can visualize our cost categories in the other cost management tools in AWS. I'm going to go to my team cost category and click View in AWS Cost Explorer. In my Cost Explorer, I'm going to change my time horizon to month to date, since that's where we began collecting cost category information. And what you can see here is the Cost Explorer is presenting to me my costs broken down as those allocated to Team A in green, Team B in blue, and those costs that cannot be allocated to any team based on my formula in red. This concludes this edition of the AWS Builder Guides. If you have feedback or suggestions, please contact us at the email address listed here. Thank you for watching.